Whenever you see an ace archer like Robin Hood performing, you always hope for that the archer hits the bullseye every time. Like here, Robin Hood is splitting the arrow which has hit the bullseye. What if the target is human eye? What are the critical elements in the human eye which, when affected, can lead to irreversible loss of vision? In cornea, the central 3 mm is a very crucial zone, as any trauma in this area will lead to irreversible loss. If lens is hit in the central 9 mm zone, then it leads to cataract, which leads to further surgery. In cases of a posterior segment of the eye, like the optic nerve and the retina, what are the crucial structures? Though every part of retina is very critical and any injury to retina, even in the periphery, can lead to detachment, it is the central zone which involves this and the macula. If that area is hit by foreign body or during trauma, it leads to irreversible loss of vision, which cannot be restored by any surgery. So hereby, I present to you an interesting case of an arrow that missed everything. A 5-year-old boy, there was a trauma by arrow while fighting with his sister. He presented with vision of 2x60. On slit lamp examination, there was a wooden foreign body which is visible. On fundus examination and ultrasound, there was a wooden foreign body linear which was impacted in peripheral part of the retina. We decided to go ahead with foreign body removal by doing 23 gauge pars plana vitrectomy. Here the vitrectomy was done so that we can relieve all the adhesions or the vitreous which is adherent around the foreign body which is impacted in the retina. If we try to remove the foreign body without doing this, it might lead to retinal avulsion or tear, which may lead to further retinal detachment. Here I am using 23 gauge vitrectomy to release all the vitreous and remove vitreous around the foreign body which is impacted in the peripheral part of the retina. After this, I am doing laser retinopexy around this impacted foreign body so that after removal of the foreign body, the tear which is formed or the hole which is formed will not lead to retinal detachment in future. After releasing the foreign body from the vitreous and retina, I am carefully taking out the foreign body through the same wound to which it has gone in. And to our surprise, it is a very long wooden foreign body which measured almost 20 millimeters. Luckily, it had not hit any of the critical structures as I had mentioned before. There was a small piece of foreign body which was left in the cornea, which I noticed at the end, so I used 25 gauge intravitreal forceps to remove this small chip of foreign body, a small chip of wooden foreign body which was impacted in the cornea, thus avoiding extension of the wound. At the end of surgery, the ports were closed. This was a sutureless 23 gauge surgery. And to a surprise, post-operative after 1 month, there was no cataract, no detachment, no endophthalmitis, and vision restored to 6x6. So he was the one lucky boy who was hit by a foreign body 20 mm long, but still he could recover the vision. So I hope every time the arrow misses the bullseye when the target is human eye. Thank you so much.